for maintenance, or welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to hook up an ice maker line for a mobile home or manufactured home or any other place where you have push-pull valves. These are more common to mobile homes, but you do see them out there in traditional homes as well. So let's get started. Today I'll be hooking up an ice maker line for a mobile home, and this ice maker line has not been used in a while. So I definitely want to flush the water line before I actually use it. So with these, this is you push it to turn it on and pull it to shut it off. So I'm going to push in the water line while I hold the hose in the bucket, and then I'll pull it to turn it off. And it did slash me a little bit, but it was worth it to flush the line out to get all that debris out of there. And now I'm ready to hook up my water line. So, right back here, go ahead. Okay, today I'm hooking up a ice maker for Frigidaire. It's got a filter on the water line. So water, ice maker, and the door. And what I have is hose right here. Very simple. Just gonna hook it up right here. So here's the hose line. Just gonna hook up the water line here, and it's better to use an adjustable wrench for that, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and we'll just go a quarter turn past tight, and then we'll turn on the water and test it out. Okay, so I got an adjustable wrench just to keep the threads going good. Hey boo. As you can see, it splashed me pretty good, but that's all right. At least I got to flush the stuff that's been sitting in there for who knows how long. Just give it a little quarter turn past tight, just so it's snug. We don't need to go super crazy or anything. We'll turn the water on, and then we'll leak test it. And we're ready to push our deal down, turn our water on. And I'm gonna grab a rag, clean this up, and make sure I have no water coming from our connector itself. And I do have a bit of water coming from there. Let's slide this down. Give it a look here. Looks like we're okay, but I'm gonna dry that up and check it out, verify. Okay, toilet paper works really good for this because it's very absorbent. So, just wanna dry this all up, and then make sure I've got no leaks here. I did get sprayed pretty good, so. Slide this down, take a look and make sure. Got some tape on there. Yeah, you don't want any surprises later. Especially for mobiles, as they've got a plywood subfloor, so any water can do damage in a real hurry.
Plywood and or press board.
In a real quick hurry. I do believe we're good there. No leaks there. And then at our hose line there, no leaks there. And then we'll want to cycle through some water and empty out all the water, just to make sure. Yeah, and that's these push-pull connectors. A little bit different than what you see on most houses, although they are used sometimes, just not quite as often. So you pull them to turn it off, and you push it to turn the water back on. Definitely good to know. Water line is hooked up. We're gonna want to run the water and drain out quite a bit of water, as well as peek back there. Again, make sure nothing is leaking at all. Here comes the water, and we're definitely gonna want to empty out about 6 cups of water, maybe more. Let it sit for a while and empty some more. It's purging all the air from the system, and again, gonna empty just to make everything good. And you might say, well, you're wasting water. Well, I'm actually on a septic system, so it's watering the yard one way or another, so not really wasting water. And it needs to be done to purge it, keep everything clean, make it healthier. There we go. And this has options for cubed ice or crushed ice. I kind of like cubed, so I'm going to switch it over to cube, and we've got a light here, so that's pretty cool, in the door for our deal. Okay, maybe one more glass of water, we're all set. Now I can remove the sticker. Remove all the plastic, get it all set up nice and neat. Before I do that, I'll do another final check, make sure we have no leaks in the back, and then I can push it back where it's supposed to go. Okay, so now we'll do a final test and a field test. Pretty sure that's just left over earlier, but I'm gonna need to monitor that. And we're good there. But right here, I definitely have some moisture there. This one was leaking a little bit and was just an easy repair of holding the bottom pipe with one hand and turning the top fitting clockwise while pushing down a little bit.
That
sealed off the leak, no big deal.
There we go. Anyway, that's how to hook up a ice maker line on a mobile home. Push-pull connector.
Good to go. And this I will monitor, make sure there's no leaks. If I need to replace the push-on connector, I'll do that. Okay, and I just turned my connector to aim this way to give me a little more room, and now everything is all nice and dry. No leaks, good to go. Okay, so here goes the ice test here. Definitely gonna dump the first few rounds of ice. And see if you can see why. Yeah, not the worst I've seen on the ice, but still better to dump the first few rounds and then be normal. Ice and water. Thanks for watching Kung Fu Maintenance. Over and out. So you probably heard that crazy beeping sound in the back of the video there. Check out my video on how to get rid of that beeping sound when you're first hooking up a Samsung refrigerator. It's an up-and-coming video. Hope to be bringing you guys plenty more videos, so thanks for watching Kung Fu Maintenance. As always, you can get parts and supplies and even the whole refrigerator or appliances on my website, kungfumaintenance.com. Just do a search in the top right-hand corner for anything you're looking for, and I make a small commission on anything you order through there, so helps me do what I do. Once again, thanks for supporting Kung Fu Maintenance.